Hello and welcome to Neha's Cook House with Dal Makhni. Dal Makhni is one of the most popular dish in Indian restaurants and roadside dhabas. This creamy, buttery and spicy lentil soup is made with black lentils and kidney beans, further enhanced with ginger, garlic and tomato flavors. So let's start making it and go through the ingredients. 1 cup black lentils, 1/4 cup kidney beans, 1 cup tomato paste, 1 tablespoon ginger paste, 1 tablespoon garlic paste, salt according to taste, 2 tablespoon finely chopped green chilies, 1 tablespoon kasuri methi, 3 tablespoon butter, 1/2 cup heavy milk cream, 1 teaspoon turmeric powder, 2 teaspoon kashmiri red chili powder, 1 teaspoon coriander powder, 1 teaspoon cumin powder, 1 teaspoon garam masala. So let's start the recipe. First of all, clean lentils to get rid of any impurities like stones. Then wash them 4 to 5 times thoroughly with water to further clean them. I have already washed both lentils and kidney beans. So let's soak them for 4 to 5 hours to make them soft. They have been soaked well, so now we will boil them in pressure cooker. For this, add 5 cups of water in a cooker. Then add lentils, kidney beans and 1 teaspoon salt. We are adding salt, which helps in boiling beans quickly. Now close the pressure cooker and cook for 15 to 20 minutes on high heat. If you don't have pressure cooker, you can also boil lentils and kidney beans in a pot. For this, use 6 to 7 cups of water and boil them till lentils and kidney beans become soft. When cooker's pressure has released by itself, we will open it to check if lentils are cooked. Both lentils and kidney beans look soft and perfectly boiled. Now transfer around 1/2 cup of cooked beans in a separate bowl and grind them into a smooth paste like this. We will use it later in the recipe. Now take a pan or pot and put on medium heat. Then add 2 tablespoons butter. When butter gets medium hot, add green chilies and saute for 30 seconds. Now add ginger and garlic paste. Mix it well and cook on medium heat for around 2 minutes till paste rawness goes away. Once ginger and garlic paste is cooked, add turmeric and Kashmiri red chili powder. Now mix them again and cook for 20 to 30 seconds on medium heat. Now it's time to add tomato paste and mix them a little. Now add some salt, but be careful as we also added salt while boiling beans. Now add coriander powder, cumin powder and mix them well. Cook the mixture for around 10 minutes on medium heat till tomato paste are cooked and all water dries out. Now tomato mixture looks cooked. So add boiled lentils. Lentil paste we made earlier. And mix it well. Adding lentil paste give nice smoothness and creaminess to dal and makes it delicious. Now add garam masala and kasturi methi to give nice flavors to dal. At this moment, if you find lentil mixture is too thick, then you can also add some water to make it thin. I have added 1 cup of water. If you want, you can also add a pinch of red food color to enhance dal color. Give dal a nice stir so that all new ingredients mix well. Now let it get a boil on high heat. When it gets a boil, put the heat to low, cover it and cook for 20 to 25 minutes on low heat. Now lentils are cooking for last 25 minutes, so let's check it. You can see the color and texture of dal has changed and it's looking great. At this time, I have also added some butter for buttery taste, but this is optional. Now mix it till butter melts away. Since it is dal makhni, at last add 1/2 cup of heavy milk cream and mix it well. And then switch off the heat. Now our delicious dal makhni is ready. So take it out in a bowl and garnish further by spreading some cream and green coriander on top. Our dal makhni is looking beautiful with right color and texture. The creaminess and richness of milk cream, butter and spice mixture gives heavenly taste. It's usually served with naan, roti or boiled rice. It's one of my favorites, so try it and don't forget to share your dal makhni pictures. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please like it and don't forget to subscribe my channel. For latest recipes, please follow Neha's Cookhouse on all social media. Have a healthy evening.